to this goose place is called Gospel Convoy. And I played something for you in first song, Psalm 4, verse 18 through 21. With that title, this message, Three Over Fear. It says here, verse 18, says, there. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out fear, because fear hath ferment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. We love him because he first loved us. If a man say, I love God, and hateth his brother, he is a liar. For he that loveth not his brother, whom he hath seen, how can he love God, whom he hath not seen? And this commandment have we from him, that he who loveth God love his brother also. You probably say to me, what do you mean in those verses? Those verses, as we talk about the side of love, are also silly of a fear. See, a lot of people nowadays fear all kinds of things in their days. You see, when the idea of what we're going to do in our life is to send the word of God. We need to be teachers. We need to teach in ourselves all things, like he commanded us to do in Matthew 28 through 19 and 20. Said, says, go therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. The ideal, what that is talked about, we need to go and tell our nations. That means the whole entire world. Everybody needs to know the word of God. It's almost like the other convoy. Every one of us had to hop into a semi-12, go down the road, where they tell the gospel. Although you don't have to, get into a semi-12 to tell the gospel. But it's just the idea of it. The idea is you need to be part of the cavalry or you're not. It's about teaching in yourself all things. You need to go and teach our nations in yourself all things so you can learn the Bible thing. That Jesus suffered and died on the cross for our sins. If you don't want no part of it, then you are missing out on a great opportunity. But in other words, you are sinking like the Titanic. To get from Titanic into this convoy, you must be able to get on that life. You need to be able to get on that lifeboat, and that's like. go to the cross. The cross, that's where Abel found the light. Go to him. That's the only way. A lot of people have fear. A lot of people don't exactly fear God, but they fear anything else in this world. They fear politics. They fear their life. They fear that their money will be gone. There's a lot of things in this world that we able to fear. But there's something that God wants us to know, that we can overcome those fears by having truly hope, and we can have truly over our fears. You see, although you are saying to me, Jesus, how can I be happy in this time when life is impossible, when life is so impossible to live? I know it's so upsetting right now. It's so crazy out there. That right is not wrong, and wrong is not right. It's ridiculous how this life can be the way it is. But the poor thing is, God, when you are right on the gospel, God tell you that you are right. That you are right to be in a convoy. You are right to tell the gospel. If you be there to tell the gospel, make no difference what other people will think, but what he thinks. We need to focus more on God than anything else, because that's the only way to make your nation great again. That's the only way to make it great again. It's by putting your heart and your life into the Word of God. You see, this nation is falling down since a lot of Titanic is sinking. Don't be like that. Be more like Noah and the ark. That boat sailed across a fully flooded, raining, wild water. You see, when sin happens, it's enough to make a flood. It's so bad enough that killing a semi truck cannot get through. But the flood I'm talking about is when there's no way a truck can get through, because this one will break a convoy in half. Because it's cut from the whole world. And there's no land whatsoever. All the trucks, all the semi trucks will be flooded and everything. But you see, in the last days, right will be wrong, and wrong will be right. The only way to get out of it is to get on the lifeboat. To get on that lifeboat and sail through. You need to get on that convoy and keep going. With the reading of the Gospels to peace and as of all things. No matter what people gonna do, you need to focus more on the Word of God. That's the only way we can get through. This verse says, heaven is my home. I'm just here recruiting. That's what I'm doing. It's my job as a command of God to recruit everyone to get to heaven. I promise it for myself. Enough to send his only begotten Son, that whosoever to believe on him, so the person may have everlasting life. God loves you, and he loves you first. But the only way for you to is experience that is by you. Give him the opportunity to. Go to the cross, able to get to heaven. See, I don't want you to go to hell. I don't want you to go to hell. Never does God. But it's almost like this. The only way to take care of this problem is put the devil in his place. I say no. When you be doing that, you give the devil a hard time. More likely, you might get the devil. Filled in anger and get the devil, and I am attacking you. When you saints arrive to follow Christ, but make no difference what the devil can do and what the devil cannot do. The devil is as powerful as God is and cannot miss him. But the only way we can have victory over the devil is by the word of God. Because God created everything, and he will win in final course. Because the Bible did say that he's going to win. Even when the devil come to steal, to kill, and destroy, he's doing that today. The devil wants you to sink, just like the Titanic. Don't let the devil make you sink like that boat. That sad Titanic boat. He wants to take you down to the lowest depths as he could, but God has a way to keep you from the devil's hands. It's by your trust, your faith, your love, and your joy, and everything else. It's all in his hands, and it's all in this world. God has the winning hand here. The devil has no winning hands to play, but he's still able to play us through. He managed to bear, Satan himself is a bear. He's a roaring bear of lion. He's scared. The devil's scared that he's going to be defeated in the last days, and he knows it, and all you have to do is to trust in God to keep you through the last days. But you see, the last days is coming quickly, but it's not here yet. I'm not here to frighten you, to put you in panic. I'm here to help you to be prepared what's going to happen in the last days. But the only way for you to be prepared in the last days is to put your heart straight to God and ask him to forgive your sins. And you're able to get out of all of these snares. Snares, troubles, and everything, including the last days. There's a lot of bad times that are going to happen in the last days that you don't want to be here. There's nobody wants to be here in the last days, because the Bible says it gets worse and worse and worse until he comes back again. But in that matter, he's going to take all those believing him and send them to heaven. The dead will arise and they go to heaven of those who believed in him and be forgiven by him. And he will win, and he's going to win in final course. He's not going to stop. He's a real cop. He's a real man, and he's real going to win. no nothing can stop him from being where he is. Not even police officer can even stop God. Nobody can stop God. His one mission is for us to tell others about him so they can show us in heaven when he finally gives the word of confession. This is a warning convoy. The only way to show this convoy is to believe on the word of God, that accepting him and repent of your sin. That's the only way to get this through. All the other ways is more like seeking God to take that. Don't let the devil do that to you. Don't let the devil take you away and throw you on the Titanic and sink. You need to get on a lifeboat and get on Noah's Ark and able to be saved by that one way. See, Noah's Ark able to ride through the storm and the wild winds and rain and sponge to things that have a turtles from these. But you don't want to be those people that have died in the flood. That are drowned and everything. There's no way you can scuba dive with those crevels and still be alive in that flood. You need to move on. You need to find your way to the store. You need to get yourself on the lifeboat and then get on Noah's Ark. The only way to get out of that flood is by trusting God. You need to put yourself in his favor. Put yourself in his mercy. You know, and go on to the cross. You don't have to go to Israel to find that cross where Jesus died on. Because there's no need to. You can do it at home. You can do it at home, work, school, you walk. Make no difference where you at. Make no difference if you are in your car. God can save you that time. If you need to pull over and repent of your sin, please do so. Because nobody would like to commit a wreck because you are waiting on the Lord. Nobody would like to hurt themselves and kill themselves on the road because somebody's waiting to be saved by God, waiting to be forgiven. All you have to do is just show the convoy and pull over. Show them the word of God. It can't be all in here. It can't be half in. No. It cannot be half in. You need to be all in. That's the only way to show this convoy. So I want to thank you again. And remember, God loves you. He loves you a lot. Don't get on that Titanic because it will sink like ever before. Get yourself on the lifeboat. Get yourself on the lifeboat and go to Noah's Ark. Because that able to stay afloat and stay true. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, if ever stay, Lord, just help us to get on the lifeboat and get on those arms. And put ourselves in. Be saved by your goodness, Lord. We need to stay away from the Titanic, Lord. We don't need to sink. We need to be forgiven. We need to get into You're powerful, your lord. We need to stay together and fight this through. Thank you, Lord, for this day. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. Thank you, bye. But it's great again.